everyone, it's Diane and this is the Angel Hug for Monday the 13th of May, and I'm going to start with the Ascended Masters cards because I still think as Ascension is an ongoing theme, I've got to stop there. They really are the best place to go to get advice and to get guidance on where we are and where we need to go next. And I'm feeling that this week we could look at gratitude, because really what we're doing with these angel hugs is we're not predicting things, we're not telling you what to do, we are just opening up a divine space, and I'm allowing a certain amount of divine guidance to come through regarding how to raise our frequency and how to get comfort and love in these times of shift and ascension, and how to actually manage all of these new energies coming into the planet, how to manage our personal energetic space, how to really take care of ourselves as well and to ride these waves, and how to also view our ascension as a process, and a process that we can actually participate in and enjoy and sometimes observe, rather than expecting it to be and shape and mold and create, manifest, rather than seeing it as a passive event that's happening to us. We decided to participate in this ascension before we came into this lifetime. So really what we're doing here, and in all the other spaces where you go to find guidance, because I know there are many, what we're really doing is we are constantly reaffirming our choices in that sense, our decision to go forward into this new consciousness and to create a new reality, and the support that we hope, that I hope to give, and that my guides and the angels are hoping to give in this space, is really to just hold our hands on a human level as we go through into more of a divine consciousness. So with that in mind, gratitude is what they've asked me to focus on this week, and it feels as if that the reason for that is because we are always looking for ways to raise our frequency. We're always looking for the next thought, the next consciousness, the next practical thing, the next methodology that we can utilize with this in mind. And gratitude is one of the fastest ways to raise our vibration. Gratitude and love. Sometimes we get to love through gratitude, is what I'm being told, though. Sometimes we don't always feel like opening our hearts because things happen around us that cause us to close down or to be afraid or to feel as if things are never going to change and we're kidding ourselves and what the heck's going on anyway. And sometimes it takes some very small thing that we notice that we suddenly realize we are so grateful for to open the heart again. Something beautiful can open the heart. A sunset can open the heart. Looking at a beautiful radiant landscape, looking at flowers, connecting with animals, things like this, realizing how fortunate we are to be breathing, to be alive, to be able to sleep somewhere comfortable at night, to be warm or to be cool if you live in a hot country, or to just feel safe. Some people don't have that. So this week is all about how to open our hearts through gratitude, and through doing that to raise our frequency and the frequency of the planet once again. So with that in mind, let's see what card we've got. So we've got mother, wife, sister, daughter, and we've got Lady Nada is the Ascended Master on that card. And the feeling that I'm getting from this is that it's a day. Monday is a day. It's perfect, really, because it was Mothering Sunday yesterday. Monday is a day to show gratitude for the feminine energy, to show gratitude for the divine feminine, to show gratitude for the women in our lives who are really important, who have shaped our lives, shaped our consciousness. I'm feeling really emotional thinking about it. Thinking about the generations of women who came before us, who have given us our lives, given us the advantages, the opportunities, the freedoms that we have today, sometimes by sacrificing their lives and their freedoms, by showing a huge capacity for love. And that will be there somewhere in your life. You might not recognize it immediately in your own mother. We don't all have perfect relationships with our mothers, and light workers notoriously have quite tricky family backgrounds and challenging past, challenging personal histories. So really what this card is about is nurturing the feminine aspect of the self, and having real gratitude for anywhere in our lives that we can see that consciousness of compassion, of giving, of caring, of nurturing, and really appreciate how that has shaped us, how that has reminded us uniquely as a consciousness, a human consciousness, and as an individual, reminded us what is really important in life. Because so many of us are striving to achieve something now. It seems that the consciousness has shifted very much towards what can we achieve? What can we get? How can we prove ourselves? This whole culture of fame, what can we do? How can we make our mark? How can we distinguish ourselves in the world? Whereas the balance needs to be tipped back in favour of who are we loving? Who are we caring for? What are we sharing? What are we actually bringing of ourselves? Where do we make sacrifices to show, to share, and to give love on this planet? Because that is really the energy of the divine feminine, and that is the energy of the mother. And wherever you can find that in your life today, have gratitude for it, whether that comes to you through a friend, through actually your mother, from within yourself, from a guide or master or teacher that you have in your life, from a best friend, from a sister, even from a daughter. Let's celebrate the divine feminine and the loving feminine here on earth as well, as we seek to rebalance those energies so that we can have a consciousness that really does serve a higher evolution for us now. We've progressed hugely in terms of technology and achievements in recent years, decades, centuries. Now it's time for us to perhaps progress in terms of coming back into the heart, coming back into our more compassionate nature. So have a lovely Monday today. It's also, you know, the day after Mothering Sunday, as I said, and also Monday, traditionally the day of the moon, which is associated usually with the feminine energies. So enjoy that. And we've got a great new moon as well that we're still feeling the vibration of. So perhaps you could include in your intention the desire to become more compassionate and to become more in touch with this aspect, whether you do so through remembering wife, sister or daughter, or the divine feminine itself. Happy Monday, everyone.